Welcome again to Art Beat. I'm Jeffrey Brown. War Horse was a major hit on Broadway, was turned into a film, and now it is touring the country in a national production. The star of the theater production is a horse named Joey, not a real horse, but a 7-foot creation, a puppet that does some astounding and mesmerizing things on stage. It's the creation of the Handspring Puppet Company of South Africa. Part of the play is now at the Kennedy Center for the Performing Arts here in Washington, D.C., and we have with us Danny Yoerges. Yoerges, like gorgeous.
Exactly.
Okay, I'll get it right. An actor who serves as the head of the horse on stage.
Correct.
Now, I want to start there. What does that mean? Explain to us what that means.
So the horse is operated by 3 puppeteers. One we call the head puppeteer, one the heart, and one the hind. Mm-hmm. And in tandem, we work to make the horse both move and also we sort of breathe emotional life into it. So without speaking to each other, because we're all mic'd and we make the horse noises throughout the show, we're able to direct this puppet around the stage and tell it. Pretty compelling story, I think.
Well, you know, I saw the New York production, so I did see it. And what was interesting was seeing people inside and then not seeing them. Yeah. I mean, are we supposed to see you or not supposed to see you?
Well, that's a very good question. When they first started sort of conceptualizing the show, uh-huh. they thought, you know, maybe we should hide the puppeteers. But Basil and Adrian of the Handspring Puppet Company had been involved with puppetry, bunraku puppetry, which is puppetry where the puppeteers are completely visible the whole time. And that's what they wanted to do because they recognized that if they tried to hide the puppeteers, people would just be looking for them.
Yeah, like what's going on?
Yeah,
where,
oh,
working?
I see them, you know? Yeah. But when they're right out in the open, then people can accept that within 5 minutes and then they just sort of fade away.
Yeah.
And suddenly it's a horse.
Now, you yourself did not have experience with puppetry.
No. Yeah, I'm an actor by trade. Many people are actors and dancers. There are a few puppeteers. But when this all started, it was new to basically everybody in the room. And, you know, we had the Handspring guys there with us holding our hands the whole way. Mm-hmm. Now we have this new skill set on our resumes.
So what did they tell you? I mean, what's the key to making it work?
It's complicated. I think the key has to do with listening to each other and breathing with each other in the puppet and really treating the puppet, the horse, like it's a real live being so that even though you have choreography, which they give us, the horse has to be listening to its surroundings. So if something happens that's new one night, you know, a new mm-hmm. sound or an actor is louder or something, the horse has to react to that. And when that happens, the audience sees those little things.
So this is just like acting on stage.
Just like acting on stage, yeah.
How is it different for you? Because normally you are acting as a human being on stage, right?
I think a really positive way that it's different is that when you're a part of a team creating a character, and when the character doesn't say any words, it's hard to let your ego get in the way because there's kind of nothing that no one's looking at you mm-hmm. when you're up there. Actors are notorious for having big egos. So when you go up there and you just give your whole body over to a horse, to being a horse, it's a nice release.
It looks physically demanding.
It is. It's extreme.
It is.
We have a physical therapist with us all the time, every
really?
Show. So
because you're carrying some weight and then somebody gets on the horse.
Exactly. The two guys on the inside, you know, they're sort of shrugged up all the time like this and they have the weight of the 120-pound horse and 170-pound human on top of them.
Yeah.
And I'm up there holding the horse's head, you know, above my head. I've got these crazy forearm muscles now, these little tiny things that I never thought existed.
You know, I saw an interview with one of the Handspring Puppet Company people and he said they wanted to originally, when they were conceiving this, discover how a horse thinks. So that's part of it, too.
Absolutely. And we watched a lot of footage of actual horses. We went to...
Oh, you did?
Yeah, we did.
Really?
And we went to stables in Brooklyn and in the Bronx and watched these, you know, attitude-y New York horses, you know, fighting each other. And
really?
It was really fun. And, you know, we're still learning how horses think. Mostly it has to do with the fact that horses are prey animals. So if something happens that could endanger their lives, they're going to respond to it in sort of a fight or flight way. But at the same time, they befriend people and just like Joey becomes Albert's best friend throughout this show.
So is there, I mean, now I'm curious, is there an interaction between the horse the horses, because there's more than one, mm-hmm. and the actors. I mean, what is, normally you would be making eye contact, right? And you'd have some relationship to them. Here you are having a different kind of relationship.
Yeah, well, I mean, from my perspective, what I do is I stare into the eyes of this horse the whole time. And the horse's eyes are looking at its surroundings. And whenever it interacts with a person, I have to basically put myself inside the head of the horse. Mm-hmm. So I get close to something that I want to be affectionate to, or I shy away from something that mm-hmm. I don't want to be. And the people, it's amazing how the actors completely give over to that reality. They start to look at the horse like it's a real horse, and they'll touch it like, and they'll pull it like it's a real horse. And sometimes we have to remind them, hey, we're actors here. We're not that strong.
Well, why do you think that this has touched so many people, this play?
I think it's touched so many people because the horse that is the central character of the show is inherently unbiased in a world around it that is extremely chaotic. It takes place during World War I. Mm-hmm. And the fact that the horse can love a person from either side of the war and that it has compassion for everything around it, it's a window that the audience can really look at the world through and really feel at peace with it, I think.
And what about you? You've got another year or so mm-hmm. with this production, but then do you want to go back to playing a human?
I'm not sure, actually. You know, I really like this puppetry thing, but I don't know. You know, maybe Lion King after this, you know.
All right, War Horses at the Kennedy Center in Washington now, and we'll continue its trek around the country, right? Danny Yoerges.
Yes.
Got it. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you, Jeff.
And thanks again for joining us on Artbeat. I'm Jeffrey Brown.